This is olivine, a carbon dioxide-eating mineral that begins its journey from the Earth's interior. It arrives on the surface thanks to plate tectonics. When hot molten rock crystallizes and solidifies into igneous rocks, olivine is trapped within it. You can also find fragments of eroded olivine lying on the Papakolia beach in Hawaii, Talofofo in Guam, Punta Coromant in Galapagos Islands, and Hornindalsvatnet in Norway. The olive-green colored mineral gives the four beaches a greenish tinge. This mineral is also mined for industrial applications. Climate scientists have their eyes fixed on olivine for its carbon dioxide extracting property. How does olivine extract CO2? And can humans harness the potential of this mineral to tackle the climate crisis? In our previous videos, we spoke about how the climate crisis is changing our planet. We discussed how it is linked to agriculture and Bitcoin mining. We looked at seaweed and its potential role in mitigating the crisis. We also virtually traveled to the North Pole looking at how the Arctic is changing. We saw what the science says about warming temperatures and the mosquito menace. Please do watch them if you haven't yet. On 9th August 2021, IPCC, the climate science body of the United Nations, released a report on the latest findings on the state of the planet. The report warned that the average surface temperature is likely to increase by 2 degrees Celsius compared to the pre-industrial era by 2060. We have no time to waste. We need to act quickly. But some scientists warn that replacing fossil fuels with renewables won't be enough. We need to extract carbon dioxide from the air and store it elsewhere. This process of sucking and locking up CO2 is called carbon sequestration. Scientists and entrepreneurs around the world are testing various technologies to do just that. Some think we can borrow a trick or two from the Earth's playbook. Forests naturally capture carbon dioxide from the air. Magnesium-rich igneous rocks do the same. Olivine is magnesium-rich. Its formula is Mg2SiO4. Olivine is preferred because it is present in copious amounts on Earth. Carbon dioxide in the air dissolves in rainwater and forms carbonic acid. This weathers or breaks down olivine. Carbonic acid and olivine fragments enter river streams, which carry them into the ocean. Here, in a series of reactions, the carbonic acid breaks down to form carbonate. It then reacts with calcium ions in the ocean to form calcium carbonate, a compound that helps corals build their outer skeletons. When these organisms die, they eventually form limestone. This way, they seal carbon for millions to hundreds of millions of years. Further, hydrogen ions released during this reaction are gobbled up by olivine fragments to form dissolved silicate. Hydrogen ions are known to increase ocean acidity. Olivine can control ocean acidification, which could harm marine life. Through weathering, rocks capture roughly 1 gigaton of CO2 per year, according to scientists. The downside is that the process is slow, which means it cannot keep up with the rate at which we are pumping CO2 into the atmosphere. Instead of waiting to let nature take its course, would it make better sense to grind olivine ourselves and spread them out on agricultural lands or coastlines? Well, this might work. It is believed that broken down particles can quickly suck CO2 due to their large surface area. Scientists call this process enhanced weathering. In an industrial setup, olivine-rich rocks are ground to a fine powder, which is then mixed with water and CO2 in a reaction vessel. At present, we are pumping about 50 billion tons of carbon dioxide equivalent each year. Through enhanced weathering, we could potentially capture billions of tons of CO2 per year. But few details need to be ironed out. Here are the three questions that still need answering. First is the energy requirements. A study suggested that grinding olivine to a fine size requires temperature and carbon dioxide pressures of 100 to 185 degrees Celsius and 4 to 15 megapascal. This makes the process energy intensive. To make up for 30% of worldwide 1990 carbon dioxide emissions, we would need to distribute 5 gigatons of olivine per year, according to the same study. This means we'll have to transport the mineral all over the world. Second, costs. Mining, grinding, transportation, and distribution add to the costs. According to an analysis, enhanced weathering could cost $70 to $578 per ton of CO2 sequestered. Third, what about the effects on the environment? Olivine contains magnesium, silica, iron, nickel, and other trace elements. We don't know how these ions will affect the ocean ecosystem. Scientists will continue studying the possible side effects exhaustively. Proponents of enhanced weathering argue that switching to renewables instead of fossil fuels could help address the energy concerns. Some are testing whether energy from waves can be exploited to break up olivine. This could reduce costs and energy use. When olivine is used on croplands, it could reduce the reliance on fertilizers and pesticides. And this could bring down the cost of producing food. That was olivine, a prolific carbon dioxide eater. Do you think we should start deploying olivine on a large scale because we are running out of time to tackle the climate crisis? Or should we wait for further studies? Do let us know in the comments section. We'll be back with another episode of Explained. Stick around.